the Lord became my protector. He brought me out to a place of freedom. He saved me because he delighted in me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. To keep the law is a great oblation, and he who observes the commandments sacrifices a peace offering. In works of charity, one offers fine flour, and when he gives alms, he presents his sacrifice of praise. To refrain from evil pleases the Lord, and to avoid injustice is an atonement. Appear not before the Lord empty-handed, for all that you offer is in fulfillment of the precepts. The just one's offering enriches the altar and rises as a sweet odor before the Most High. The just one's sacrifice is most pleasing, nor will it ever be forgotten. In a generous spirit, pay homage to the Lord. Be not sparing of freewill gifts. With each contribution, show a cheerful countenance, and pay your tithes in a spirit of joy. Give to the Most High as he has given to you, generously according to your means. For the Lord is one who always repays, and he will give back to you sevenfold. But offer no bribes, these he does not accept. Trust not in sacrifice of the fruits of extortion, for he is a God of justice who knows no favorites. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God. Gather my faithful ones before me, those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. And the heavens proclaim his justice, for God himself is the judge. Hear my people, and I will speak. Israel, I will testify against you. God, your God am I. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Offer to God praise as your sacrifice, and fulfill your vows to the Most High. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me, and to him that goes the right way I will show the salvation of God.
To the upright I will show the saving power of God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to little ones the mysteries of the kingdom.
Alleluia, alleluia. and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter began to say to Jesus, "We have given up everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands for my sake and for the sake of the gospel who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecutions and eternal life in the age to come. But many that are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Today the Church gives us 4 options for Mass. Obviously, I chose the option of Tuesday in the 8th week in Ordinary Time, but we also have 3 different saints who lived in 3 different eras. Saint Bede the Venerable, Pope Saint Gregory the VII, and Saint Mary Magdalene di Piazzi. And I thought that the gospel today can give justice to all 3. If we take 1 line, Peter says, "We have given up everything and followed you." And this is from Mark's gospel today. Other passages, Peter says, "Hey, what are we going to get? What will be our recompense for doing all of this?" And I ask all of us today, what is our recompense for doing this? We woke up this morning, those who are watching, they could watch anything else. I mean, there's all kinds of things on YouTube you could watch. There's things that you could be doing right now. Why are we here? What is the purpose? What do we get in return? Now, we can come up with a standard book answer. We get Eucharist, we get grace, etc., etc. Might I offer something else to ponder? We receive meaning. Meaning. For our life needs meaning. We have to have a purpose greater than ourselves. Something that will last. And some people try to construct that purpose by the accumulation of wealth or of material things, and these don't pan out. I mean, let's be it. Gosh, how many different pairs of shoes have we all gone through in our lifetime? Okay? Just think about that. So we can accumulate a bunch of things, but it doesn't give us meaning or purpose. And it has to be something greater than ourselves, because even if we say, "I receive purpose from doing my duty to protect my country," as a person in the armed services would, or to protect my fellow citizens, as a person who is a fire person or a police person, but yet there has to be something greater than that. We can donate money, get our names on buildings, or have someone build a statue. We can earn a Nobel Peace Prize. I think you can get those pretty much off the thing for cheap nowadays. But you can do all these things and get all these awards. But as you know, so much tarnishes and rust. So what does the one mean? It has to be something outside of us. Something that we know is eternal, that's lasting. And doing good, doing what is virtuous, like what a Saint Bede did when he followed God in his way, or Pope Saint Gregory in his way, or Saint Mary Magdalene de Piazzi in her way, each called at different times to serve God. One is a Benedictine monk, one is a Benedictine who becomes a Pope, the other is a Carmelite, who's a religious sister.
but in whatever you do, being Catholic, doing virtuous things, gives your life a meaning greater than what you do provides. And in that way, you know you're doing something right, good, worthy, that will outlast you. Because here we are, years, years removed from those three saints, and from every from so many other saints, and yet we still remember them because their life had meaning, and that meaning impacts even us to this day. So why not us? Why can't we be that next generation to impact the next generation and the next generation after that? Now, Almighty God be with you. May He bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Coming together as one family in faith, let us offer to God our prayers and our needs. We pray for Holy Father, for Archbishop, for all priests, religious brothers, sisters, permanent deacons, and seminarians. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick, are suffering in any way this day, and those who care for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the needs of our brothers and sisters who will watch this Mass on video, and for the needs of you here present in our chapel today. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Al Casello, for whom this Mass is being offered today. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Offering all our prayers to the Father, let us conclude with a prayer of praise in honor of the Blessed Trinity.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all the church.
O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name, and count our oblations as a sign of our desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant as the source of merit may also help us to attain merit's reward, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of glory, Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. So once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. So we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
healed. The Lord, who has been bountiful with me, sing psalms to the name of the Lord Most High.
Christ.
Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer to St. Michael for our families.
Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine powers, thrust into hell, Satan and all the other evil spirits, who wander through the world, seeking the ruin of the souls. Amen.
The divine praises protection against storms, hurricanes, and other disasters.
Blessed be God. Blessed be His holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, the God of the Holy Man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be His most sacred heart. Blessed be His most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Blessed be the great Mother of God, her Mary, the Most Holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious Assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and His angels and His saints.